Hi, my name is Aileé and welcome to my channel. On this video I'm gonna show you the method I use to memorize and better understand the scale modes and their relationship to each other. Let's get started. For this method we are going to use solfege. In case you're not familiar with it, let me quickly explain some basics. In solfege, we assign syllable names to every note on the scale. You probably are familiar with this.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
That is the major scale. And if we happen to be playing the C major scale, those names would correspond to all the white keys. But what about all the notes in between? The sharp and flat notes in the chromatic scale also have their own syllable names. When we are singing a sharpened note, we use the following syllables: D, Ri, Fi, Si, Li. When we are singing a flattened note, we use Ra, Me, Se, Le, Te. Here is a graphic I find very useful to help me remember all the syllable names. Now let's take a look at the modern Western modes. The modes use the same notes as the major scale, but each mode starts from a different scale degree. For example, the natural minor scale is a mode of the major scale. They use the same notes, but the natural minor scale starts on the 6th degree of the major scale, and so that becomes the tonic of the natural minor scale. The order of the modes is as follows. Starting on the 1st degree of the major scale is the Ionian mode, which, you guessed it, is just another name for the major scale. Starting on the 2nd degree is the Dorian mode. Starting on the 3rd degree is the Phrygian mode. Starting on the 4th degree is the Lydian mode. Starting on the 5th degree is the Mixolydian mode. Starting on the 6th degree is the Aeolian mode, also known as the natural minor scale. And finally, starting on the 7th degree is the Locrian mode. As you can see on this matrix, the notes of the major scale correspond to the tonics of each mode. With the method that I just showed you, there are two different ways to learn the scale modes. With the first one, you can follow the pattern of the major scale and just start singing on the syllable or scale degree that corresponds to each mode. For example, if I wanted to sing the Mixolydian mode and this was my first pitch, I know Mixolydian corresponds to the 5th degree. The syllable for the 5th degree is sol. So I would mentally try to find the sound of do. I would then continue to sing the major scale in my mind until I get to sol. From that point on, I would sing out loud from sol to sol.
Sol, la, si, do, re, mi, fa, sol, fa, mi, re, do, si, la, sol.
This is the easiest way to sing the modes, but the way I want you to learn is called movable do. In this method, the syllable do will always be assigned to whatever pitch is the tonic. The reason I want you to learn with this method is because movable do makes it easier to memorize the scale formulas and to understand how the modes relate to each other. First, we're gonna take a look at the Ionian mode, or major scale, since it's the one that's likely most secure in your mind. The formula for this scale is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and back to 1. In solfege, we sing it like this.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, ti, la, sol, fa, mi, re, do.
Then we are going to learn the Mixolydian mode. The formula for the Mixolydian mode is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, flat 7, 1, which makes the Mixolydian mode very similar to the major scale. As you can see, the only difference is the flattened 7th degree. This knowledge will help you recognize this mode when you hear it, because now you know what to look for. Now, in solfege, if you remember what I said in the beginning, when we sing flattened or sharpened notes, we assign them different syllable names. In this case, since we have a flat 7, instead of singing T, we would replace that syllable with Te. This is how we would sing the Mixolydian mode in solfege.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, te, do, te, la, sol, fa.
Next is the Lydian mode. The formula for the Lydian mode is 1, 2, 3, sharp 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. So similarly to the previous mode we learned, the only difference between the Lydian mode and the major scale is the sharpened 4th degree. And in this case, since we have a sharp note, we will be replacing Fa with Fi. In solfège, we sing the Lydian mode like this.
Do, re, mi, fi, sol, la, ti, do, ti, la, sol, fi, mi, re, do.
You want to start getting familiar with the sound and characteristics of each mode. When you practice, first start by playing each mode slowly and then go back and forth between them so that you start getting them into your ear. This is why I find it so useful to sing the modes using solfège, because it helps me to always have a reference I know really well in my mind. Now we're moving on to our second reference mode, which is the Aeolian mode, also known as the natural minor scale. After the major scale, this is the mode that people are probably most familiar with because we hear it so much in Western music. The formula for the Aeolian mode is 1, 2, flat 3, 4, 5, flat 6, flat 7, 1. In solfège, we sing this scale like this.
Do, re, me, fa, sol, le, te, do, te, le, sol, fa, me, re, do.
The next mode we are going to learn is the Dorian mode. The formula for the Dorian mode is 1, 2, flat 3, 4, 5, 6, flat 7, 1. As you can see, the difference between the natural minor scale and the Dorian mode is that the Dorian mode has a raised 6th degree. So when you're trying to recognize this mode, you can first look for that minor quality, and then you'll notice that sort of brightness that distinguishes it from the Aeolian mode because of that raised 6th. In solfège, we sing the Dorian mode like this.
Do, re, me, fa, sol, la, ti, do, ti, la, sol, fa, me, re, do.
Our final reference mode is the Phrygian mode. I personally find the Phrygian mode very easy to distinguish because it has this sort of dark and mysterious quality to it, and is used very often in metal music. The formula for the Phrygian mode is 1, flat 2, flat 3, 4, 5, flat 6, flat 7, 1. That minor second is what gives the Phrygian mode its dark flavor. In solfège, we would sing the Phrygian mode like this.
Do, re, me, fa, sol, le, te, do, te, le, sol, fa, me, ra, do.
And finally, the Locrian mode. The formula for the Locrian mode is 1, flat 2, flat 3, 4, flat 5, flat 6, flat 7, 1. As you can see, the difference between the Phrygian and the Locrian mode is that the Locrian mode has a flattened 5th degree. This is a very important distinction. If we take a look at all the modes together, you will notice that the Locrian mode is the only one that doesn't have a perfect 5th. This is why it's so difficult to compose music with this mode. Without a perfect 5th, the Locrian mode just lacks a sense of resolution, and because of that flattened 5th, the tonic chord of the Locrian mode is a diminished chord, so again, it always feels like it wants to resolve somewhere else. In solfège, we would sing the Locrian mode like this.
Do, re, me, fa, se, le, te, do, te, le, se, fa, me, ra, do.
I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments if you would like me to make another video with just exercises to aid what we learned here. If you liked this video, please share it with other people who could benefit from it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.